across the borderline. Sing it if you know it. And he's gone away yesterday. It's gone away yesterday. Now I find myself on a mountainside, where the rivers change direction across a great divide. Hey, it's gone away yesterday.
Good evening. It's a pleasure to be here in Austin and in the hometown, just basically because I've had some really good food. This next song is the title song for my latest CD, and it was inspired by the title of the last novel that Carson McCullers wrote, which was a novel about complacency of the heart. And if you're sitting in a corner and you're not taking risks in life and you're not contributing and producing and loving throughout your life in this humanity, you are wasting space and you are a clock without hands. I've left behind, crying on the shoulders of the loves that I've forgotten in. And I am frozen in time, like the battles of the soldiers, so displaced in time where their tears still fall. Loves that wreck out on the track, far beyond my looking back. This shell without hands to give the time of day to love it all. I am a clock without hands. No one understands this. That when the autumn comes, I see no reason for fall. Spring can fail to move me with its tulips and its clover. Now the time for love is over, and I am a clock without hands. I'm just ticking, and that's all. Inside this clock where my hands held the key, the innocence of passion and the words of Saint Teresa chiming in. And I recall the faith of the love of my life and the loosing of my hands which he took with him when he died. Now I'm crying. sticking in that soul. Like I'm a clock without hands, I'm just ticking in that soul. Are you sleeping now? It's midnight in Missoula, where the black hills know your name. Is a snow pile tied around your window frame? Is there enough frost left to write our names upon the pane? Are you sleeping now? It's midnight in Missoula. Are you sleeping now? It's midnight in Missoula. Children's lullabies, and wondering of you, and if you're sleeping in Missoula tonight. Oh, oh, are you sleeping now? It's midnight in Missoula. Are you sleeping now? It's midnight in Missoula. I'd love to climb your hilltops and look out upon Missoula. Sing Samuel Barber melodies with your viola sweet and high. I am off to Liverpool. An early flight. I'm wondering of you and if you're sleeping in Missoula tonight. Oh, oh, are you sleeping now? It's midnight in Missoula. The black hills know your name. Is the snow pile tied around your window frame? Is there enough frost left to write our names across the page? Are you sleeping now? It's midnight in Missoula. Are you sleeping now? Are you sleeping now? Do you know how much I love ya? Are you sleeping now? It's midnight in the zoo. Thank you. She was high up there in the air, caught still by a soldier's stare. Whenever it was men amongst men down upon felt the thunder of their guns. From a pearl's eye view, just a camera in her hand. And she was born Georgette, but the name didn't suit her well. So she flew out of Wisconsin as Dickie Chappelle. Oh, she flew with the pilot's pride, the first witness on either side. And she carried relief to the lost ones between the bombs. And she saw it all through her lens. Still she knew she'd go back again. Oh, when the call rang out once more for Vietnam. Well, she'd been to tell you war is hell, but her pearl earrings brought the light to Dickie Chappelle. Well, that's the way it was. She was the only one to tell. In 1962 she blew the whistle loud and clear, and now we trace her wings in her footsteps without me. Over Chula in a free fall dive, on a dawn patrol to cover a dead zone ground. So she tiptoed through the landmines, all along the enemy's tree lines. But she never saw the one who took her down. And she captured the bloody pearls of war. War was bound to steal the end of Dickie Chappelle. Of Dickie Chappelle. Of Dickie Chappelle. Dickie Chappelle. Long may she ride.
Be with us.
This song is from the latest CD, Clock Without Hands, and it's a song that I wrote on my first trip to Vietnam and Cambodia. And I was very moved in landing at Thon Son Nhut Airport in Ho Chi Minh City, which we all know as Saigon, and realizing that I was coming into a place where loved ones had lost their innocence, and walking through a space where my ex-husband, who is a songwriter, brilliant songwriter, Eric Taylor, had once served part of his life. 20 years taken out of a lot of veterans' lives after the war to get their lives back together. And I was very moved by that whole thing and wrote this song in the middle of the night. Called Eric Taylor up and played it for him. Good psychologist that he is now. And he said, I'll call you back in a minute. Hung up the phone, called me back, and said he'd like to send all of his ex-wives to Vietnam.
Saigon, where were you?
save this time and place. For a time when I can say I travel truth in this part of you. Where you amongst the madness on the streets of Saigon? Where were you in 1969 when I was but a youth? Oh, yeah, where you were traveling through this part of you. You were an American boy whose innocence was lost here in the war. Nothing that I've ever seen now means much of anything in this part of you. And the Vietnam that I had dreamed, the place you wore your life fatigued, I'm traveling through this part of you. I am traveling through this part of you. I am traveling this part of you. Say thank you. Thank you. God bless you. It's a pleasure to be home.
Questions, comments? Visit us at Austin City Limits at PBS Online, pbs.org.
Now, I've got a hand.